Fitbit Shorts!
Hello and welcome to Meadow Park here in Irvine, and it's Fitbit Shorts. And it's a top league game between Irvine Meadow and Beath. Now, you're a Beath man, and I'm going to ask you, once again, what's the score going to be?
2-1 Beath.
2-1 Beath, here we go. There's really nothing at stake today. I think that's the big problem, is trying to motivate players in a game like this today. Mm-hmm.
It was a poor result from Beath against the bus recently, so maybe see a reaction to that. But a lot of the time in these games, not much to play for. You just see the teams kind of coming out, not giving it their all sometimes. But hopefully not. Hopefully we'll see a good game.
Yeah, and hopefully we all do. Let's go and watch this game. And it's the last game here at Meadow Park of season 2018-19 for Irvine Meadow as they play Beath, and they're hoping to finish the season with a flourish at their home ground. It's a free kick to Meadow. It's headed clear by Beath stalwart Sheridan. Beath controlling the early stages of the game. There's number 9 Milliken trying to twist around Latta. Cleared by McLennan. Looks like they're playing upsy daisy. And eventually cleared by Green. Oh, and oops, and it looks like Slews has a hole in his shoes. And B, they're exploiting the left-hand side of every Meadow player across the pitch. Cleared by Latta. And once again, B down the left-hand side. Crossed by Milliken. And just a stretch too far for fullback McQuinchy. It's clever interplay by Bees. Ramsey slips past Gow. And it's a mix-up between Milliken and Fries. Middleton! It's blocked by Carson. And it's Meadow having to weather an early storm by Bees. Corner. It's a dangerous corner, headed clear by Devlin. It's Christie's cross, and again cleared by Devlin. And Bees piling on the pressure. Noble powering his way at Meadow. Latter clears. And corner cleared by Carson. Meadow eventually break free with Willett. It's side down by Green. Yellow card. Take the free kick. Headed away by Middleton. And it's Ramsey to chaperone it into touch. It's a long clearance by Grindley. Nodded on by Ramsey. Christie. An opportunity goal by Beath. And what you would call a route one goal. Straight from Grinley's long clearance. Ramsey gets the better of the towering Slews. Finds Crispy, who nips the ball neatly past the helpless Newman to make it 1-0 to Beath. Yes, and Beath have dominated the early periods of the game so far. And you felt it was just a matter of time before they scored. And Beath are maintaining the pressure on the Meadow defence. And the Meadow eventually have a break with Sharp, who wrestles past Sheridan. Beats Grindley, Willett! Oh, and how did he miss that? And Meadow slowly creeping back into this game. Again menacing the B defence. Corner. And Grindley punches clear in a packed area. There's B back in the attack with Fries. Corner. And it's easily cut out by Newman. The Meadow beginning to string more passes together, looking more confident. the Carson header. Oh, and Lee bundles Pearson off the ball. And referee Callum Scott has no hesitation but to send him off. And is willing to take. Oh, and a brilliant save by Grinley. And here you can see the slow-mo, a gap in the wall. Well, it tries to bend into Grinley's left, but Grinley produces a super save to keep Beath one up. And once again, it's Grinley to the rescue. And it's Meadow exploiting the 10-man Beath. Sharp to Pearson. Sharp, blocked by McQuincy. Sharp again. It was a clever flick by Christie. It's over the bar by Ramsey. And there goes a half-time whistle, with Beath leading 1-0 through a Christie opportunist goal. What will the second half bring? There's McLennan, and it's wide to Willett. It's a testing cross in no man's land, headed clear by Noble. McLennan to Pearson. Carson! Oh, that just slips past the upright. The B defence are in sixes and sevens just now. A poor clearance by Grinley. Oh, and he makes up with a good tackle to McLaughlin. This Meadow making use of the space, working the ball from left to right. McLennan. Cross to Spence. And easily saved by Grinley. It's Middleton's cross. Oh, and almost number two. McLennan to Spence. Back to McLennan. And there's appeals for the penalty. And referee Scott points to the spot. Penalty to Meadow. And here you see Middleton appears to bundle Carson off the ball. It looks soft to me, but penalty is given by referee Scott. It's Carson to take. Goal, Irvin Meadow. And Carson's spot kick is right down the middle, sending Grinley to the left. And Newman to McLennan. Christie lays off to Fries. He's brought down by Carson, right on the D. It's McGlinchey. Oh, and what a goal by McGlinchey. A terrific bender. And here you can see the Meadows wall showing far too much to the right side. And McGlinchey just tucks the ball into the open space. And can Meadow recover from that wonder goal by McGlinchey and finish the season with a win? And substitute Maguire battling down the left and eventually fouled. Carson's free kick. But it's a brilliant one-handed save by Grinley. Under severe pressure, up he goes and touches the ball onto the bar. And Meadow are running out of time, trying desperately to equalise. Beath break. Oh, and another free kick in a dangerous area. There's McGlinchey again, but this time it's too high and over the bar. There's Beath aiming for a third goal. It's headed onto Milliken. A clever back heel. Bradley! Oh, it's blocked by Gow. And it's claims for a penalty. And here you see in slow-mo, and I'm sure if you're a Beath fan, you will judge that to be a penalty. And Beath are finishing this game just like a cup tie. Fries, Milliken. Christie, cleared by Slews. That's a free kick to Meadow. Is this their last chance? Keeper Newman is up. Scramble clear. McLaughlin. Goal! Robin Meadow! A wonder goal by McLaughlin. An absolute screamer. And here you see McLaughlin unleash a thunderbolt into the back of the net, almost bursting the net. It's 2-2, and only seconds remain. And there goes the final whistle with this entertaining 2-2 draw between Every Meadow and Beath. With goals from Christie and McGlinchey for Beath and Carson and McLaughlin for Every Meadow. So let's hear from Brian McGinty.
I think I've just spoke to the boys in the papers there, and I think we didn't deserve it. They came to be brutally honest, but it's very difficult to criticise the group of players we have. I'm delighted for them that we finished like that, because I think it typifies the dressing room we've got and the spirit we've got. We didn't deserve to win the game. We didn't deserve to draw the game. It was a poor performance, but the goal at the end just typifies the spirit we've got in the dressing room. They refuse to accept getting beat, regardless of how badly they're playing, well they're playing. They've just got a real never say die attitude, and I think that was probably a fitting way to finish the season. We'd obviously like to have won, and that goal would have been better to go and take 3 points, but I think to finish in that way, which has been a really, really hard season for us, but a really good season in terms of the way we've finished after a really tough start. I think it's a great credit to the boys, and it's good that they finished in a high rather than a low. I've been really disappointed for them in there. We'd have finished with a poor performance and a defeat. Yeah, it was a poor performance, but football's about getting results, and we've dug a result out today.
Lovely hit for the boy at the end as well.
Well, I struggle to see it because I'm banned for the dugouts at the moment, so I only seen it leaving his foot in from where I was sitting. So, but no, Andy's got that quality. His technical ability is probably up there with the best, certainly one of the best at the club. And you've always got a chance with players like that. Their quality brings up moments like that. And listen, it was a great hit, but I'm just delighted for the dressing room. I really am. It would have been a really tough one with the player of the year during the night. They deserve to go and celebrate what they've done this season, which is a magnificent achievement for the club and the players, but it's nice to know when to enter the team.
We are the boys. Anyway.
Tell me you're rolling.
Yeah, we're rolling.
Thank you.
Well, we are rolling.
Yeah.
I knew you were going to do something there, so I just started.
I didn't hear that. The last bits of rain come on there, and it's ended up 2-2. You know, it's not been one of the kind of games with a lot at stake, but it's actually an entertaining game, I thought.
Both teams played open attacking football, looking to win the game, so can't complain of that. A lot of the time, end of the season, you see players kind of not going full blooded into challenges and that, but both teams gave it their all today, can't argue with that.
Yeah, they played really well. Bees come in there, they got a free kick in the second half there. One all at the time. What a goal.
What a hit.
And I'm really keen to see it back again.
Yeah, right round the wall. I think it went in off the post.
In off the post, I think. Yep. Aye, came back in. It was a great goal. But at the end of the game there, it seemed to kind of hang on. The referee was kind of saying, right,
yeah,
it seemed to have a couple more minutes added on, and then the men had got the free kick just inside there, and they fell at McLaughlin, and they literally crashed up onto the net.
Cracking finish. Wasn't lovely, it? Lovely hit.
I think, I don't know about you, I think all round, overall, 2-2 was probably a fair result.
But maybe it's the Beath boy in me, but I think we deserve more out of that game.
Yeah,
we deserve the 3 points.
There was one or two controversial moments, especially the penalty in the second half up at the top end there.
Could have been awarded a penalty, with perhaps unfortunate to have a penalty awarded against them. So, both teams put in a fight for the game. You've not taken away from them. They fought for it, they got a good goal at the end, but I'm still saying I think Beath deserves 3 points.
And Beath are still in the West of Scotland, they played with after next, so they've got something to play for them in the season. Every Meadow, to me, they're building not a bad team now, getting ready for the Premiership next year.
Yep.
So who knows what's going to happen at Meadow Park. But good luck to Beath, and you just never know if they get through again to Glenafton. It could be the Talbot.
Could be.
Yeah. Do you think they'll upset them if they do?
Always got it in us.
Ah, that's it. Anyway, it's Andrew and myself from Meadow Park here at Irvine. It's ended up 2-2 with a McLaughlin cracking goal at the very end there. Watch the game. It's a beautiful goal. See you then.